What a pleasure. Now I have APHA President-elect Tom Quade with me. Thank you for being here.
Well, thank you for the opportunity.
So next year, APHA's Year of Climate Change.
Yes.
Let's talk about how that affects all of our health.
Sure. Climate change is one of those things that we don't often identify with a specific health issue. And the reason I think for that is because it affects all of them. I can't really think of anyone that's more than a degree or two separated from the climate, the world in which we live. Whether it's being able to get outside and exercise in clean air, whether it's about having access to clean water, whether it's about having access to affordable food that isn't, you know, a problem that's exacerbated by increased costs for produce because of the climate impact on agriculture. It's ubiquitous. It impacts every single thing that we do when we're talking about health. When we go upstream, we're getting to the environment in which we live.
And we as adults worry about that, of course, and we also worry about the effect on our children because it sustained the impact on them.
Right, and they're not only they're sustained because they're getting it at an earlier age, many of the downstream health impacts, whether it's communicable disease or chronic disease, asthma, things like that, our children are far more susceptible. They're living with it far longer. They're representing that next generation. Climate change is not one of these chronic issues. Acute issues. It's a chronic issue. When we think about disease and any sort of malady, we usually think of it as an immediate thing or an acute thing versus a chronic thing. There's nothing that gets more chronic than the environment in which we live.
I know this is a tough question, but what can we do about climate change?
Yeah, there are some big picture things that we need to be doing that aren't going to change it today, but we need to start today. We need to bring in new partners. We need to do a better job of our public policy and our advocacy. In order to do that, we need to create a greater awareness. We need to have a better understanding of the science. We need better science, which means we need better surveillance. We need to have models that don't just predict things at a global level over, you know, decades, but at a local level over, you know, years, so that we can then form informed arguments when we go and talk to our policymakers that are ultimately going to change the space in which these decisions are made, whether it's how we produce our energy, how we use our energy, or any of the others.
When you're talking about this effort taking years, how much of an urgency is it then? Because it's going to take so long to affect some change.
Yeah. I think historically folks need to remember that we've never been able to pick a fight with Mother Nature and win. We need to start today to make amends with Mother Nature, or she's going to exercise some tough love on us. We need to start today.
Tom Quade, thank you so much.
My pleasure.